use this as a tutorial, like you know, on YouTube, the things on YouTube that get the most views are like how to do things.
Right.
This is DIY, like how to do a countdown. Here you go. Hope you learned something. Hey, I'm Paul McGuire. This week on The Countdown, we're going to start things off with Jason Aldean, who will join law enforcement and fire department personnel for a charity softball game called Battle of the Badges in Nashville this weekend. Funds raised will benefit the families of first responders who recently lost their lives in the line of duty. Jason's Drowns the Whiskey, featuring Miranda Lambert, drops three positions this week, but is still hanging on at number 20.
And the thing that really gets me is how your memory drowns the whiskey.
Jason Aldean, Drowns the Whiskey, featuring Miranda Lambert, down three spots to number 20. Paul Brandt's album, The Journey, YYC, Volume 1, YYC is Calgary, came out in the spring, Calgary Airport, to be specific. Yankee, Yankee, Charlie. The second half of this project, The Journey, BNA, Volume 2, BNA, Bravo, November, Alpha, that's Nashville. Volume 2 comes out November 9th and features a collaboration with a very popular Canadian guitar-playing singer-songwriter. I spent some FaceTime with Paul recently.
We talked to Tim Hicks last week, who's got an amazing song with Lindsay L.
Yes.
You also lucky enough to have her sprinkle some of her magic dust on one of your tracks. Tell me about it.
She just blows my mind. She's amazing. You know, I mean, just incredible work ethic and you know, I mean, I'm proud as a Calgary guy to see the incredible, you know, work ethic that she's got being out there representing. And I had asked Lindsay months ago, actually, I think maybe it was the last time that we had chatted. We just started talking about it months ago.
Yeah.
If she would come and play guitar on this song, Bittersweet. And it's a special song for me. You know, Brad Rempel, one of the co-writers on it. And I was really thrilled with the way that it turned out. But it just felt like it needed an energy, and she's got that energy. I mean, she's a guitar goddess. So yeah, pretty cool to see, you know, that combined effort. And I was just stoked that she said yes.
Bittersweet, featuring Lindsay L, makes its chart debut at 19. Feel Like That from the Washboard Union makes its chart debut at 18. Where you been in radios playing your brand new song? Oh, man, it's good to be back. Who wouldn't want to feel like that? And Cold Creek County's Money, featuring Mitchell Tenpenny, moves up one spot to 17. Everyone has a movie or two that they've seen so many times they can just about quote every line word for word. I've got three: Star Wars, Young Frankenstein, and Weird Science. You do not want to watch any of those movies with me. How about Carly Pierce? What's hers?
It's complicated. Meryl Streep. I'm a huge Meryl Streep fan. I think she is amazing. And I'm laughing even thinking about it. I can quote pretty much everything from it. My mom and I love it. It's Meryl Streep and Alec Baldwin. And their chemistry with Steve Martin is just so funny. And every time my mom's in town, we watch it.
Stay close to the candle. The staircase can be treacherous. I've never heard of or seen that Meryl Streep movie anyway. Perhaps Carly and her mom will rack up a few more viewings when Carly gets some time off around the U.S. Thanksgiving holidays. But for now, she's got one more weekend of shows on Luke Bryan's What Makes You Country tour. Plus, she's working on her sophomore album and continuing to watch her latest song, Hide the Wine, make its way up the charts. Hide the Wine moves up four positions to number 16 in its second week on the chart. Carly Pierce, Hide the Wine, up four spots to 16 this week. Andrew Hyatt has a brand new EP out this weekend called Kane. I spent some FaceTime with Andrew. Have a look.
So talk to me a little bit about Kane, the new EP that comes out on Friday.
Yeah, man. You know, there's every song on there is a song that when I listened to for the first time, I couldn't get it out of my head, which is why it ended up on this EP.
Okay.
Really excited for My Kind of Crazy. That's definitely in my brain from day one. First time hearing the demo, that was the song for me that I was like, this has got to be the single. And I'm just happy that everybody else on the team agreed. And,
yep.
And it turned out really well. It's something a little bit different. I don't think we've done anything that's as stripped down or as emotionally charged. You know, it's a very like real song. So I'm excited to see what it does for me.
Habit is in at number 15 for a second week in a row.
Need a couple more. It's the kind of thirst you just can't drown. This bed's a bar and I'm drinking them out. Kisses and loving, your love is a drug. I'm an addict, you're my habit.
Old Dominion's Hotel Key drops 9 positions to 14.
In a purse, I guess. It makes a think of me. And that night we left our hearts on the sleeves and the clothes all over the floor. We both know we can't open that door no more, but she kept the hotel key.
Jade Eagleson's Got Your Name On It moves up 3 spots to 13.
Well, you know, I want you in it every minute. Got a front porch seat for you, girl. If you can swing it, my start, my end, my heart, my hand. You can have it right now if you want it. It's got your name.
Who's Gonna Love You from Tay Bay moves up 2 positions to number 12.
Who you gonna call? Who you gonna kiss? Nobody's gonna put up with your shit. Who's gonna love you if I don't?
And Worth a Shot from Aaron Burchett drops 2 spots to 11.
Shooting for the moon, you're way out of my league. But I got nothing to lose. And by the end of the night, the only thing I got on my lips is Tennessee Fire. Hey!
Aaron Burchett, Worth a Shot, down 2 spots to number 11 this week. All right, 10 down, 10 to go. That's halftime, which means it's time to head to Hollywood for Zach Selwyn's 1 Minute Music Minute.
It's the 1 Minute Musical Minute. Ba-deep-bop, doo-doop, 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 doo-doop.
Hey, welcome to your 1 Minute Music Minute live from my kitchen. My name is Zach Selwyn, and I'm a huge country music fan, so what should I name my cat? Tabby Keith, Kenny Persney, or Trace Catkins? Ow! Singer Ariana Grande and Pete Davidson broke up this past week, and we were reminded that Pete Davidson has 12 Ariana Grande-inspired tattoos. Wow, I only have 9. The Who lead singer, Roger Daltrey, revealed that he fathered 3 illegitimate children with 3 different women over 40 years ago. The children said their favorite Who songs are Who Are You, A Quick One While He's Away, and a very rare B-side called That Bastard Ain't Mine. That's your 1 Minute Music Minute, and it looks like the cat votes are in. Gene Pawtry. Way to keep it current, people.
It's the 1 Minute Musical Minute. Ba-deep-bop, doo-deep, doop, doop, doop.
Thank you, Zach. Follow Zach on Twitter at Zach Selwyn. Back to the chart with Dierks Bentley, who, along with his tourmates Brothers Osborne, traveled to California's Salton Sea to shoot the video for Burning Man about the midsummer shoot. Dierks said, "The brothers and I flew out to the desert in July to shoot this. Several people on the crew had heat strokes, 2 cars got stuck in the sand, and we had to have a rattlesnake wrangler with us at all times. But we got the shots." Burning Man, featuring Brothers Osborne, moves up 7 spots to number 10 this week.
I'm a little bit holy water, but still a little bit Burning Man. Burning Man.
And Chad Brownlee's Dear Drunk Me moves up 2 positions to number 9.
I'm sober, can't go back to the way it was. Don't go messing up a good buzz. Chasing around her memory like you always do when you're drunk. Me.
Chad Brownlee, Dear Drunk Me up 2 spots to number 9 on the countdown. CMT.com. CMT. Remember CMT? Recently chatted with Maren Morris about female trailblazers in country music. She named Carole King, Dolly Parton, and Loretta Lynn, saying these women weren't wallflowers. They were completely empowering and unapologetic in their stance, and there was also this really intense vulnerability that no one was able to show at that time, especially in male artists and songwriters. You have to be a man, you have to be masculine, and not show any sort of weakness. Rawr. Women were showing their strength through vulnerability, which is why I still believe it's so necessary to showcase that. You don't turn on a song and think, if it's a woman's voice, oh my gosh, this is just about her trying to flirt with a guy and be the pretty scenery at the party. It's like, no, none of those women that I mentioned were that ever. So I try to keep that torch lit with my own songwriting and the way that I conduct myself, and I really respect the women around me today in the modern scope of music that carry that torch as well. Wow. I chatted with Maren when she was in Toronto recently about the follow-up to her debut album, Hero.
Okay, let's talk about Rich. It has been announced that it is the final single off this album, so we know we're moving forward. But there's a special place in your heart for this song as well, I'm sure.
Yeah, I mean, it's like my goofy child, the sassy one. Yeah, it's like, it's my fun side. It's me just being crazy and a mess, basically. I feel like to be a debut artist and get a fourth single on your debut album is a miracle in itself. But, you know, with I Could Use a Love Song being number one and then getting to end with a really, like, up-tempo jam. That's super funky and fun. It doesn't take itself too seriously. I feel like the world needs that right now. Just like, okay, let's take a breather and just laugh at ourselves. So that's what we kind of wanted to do after Love Song, because Love Song was so serious. So it's cool to sort of end the window of Hero on such a fun kind of like, I'm going down, not giving an F.
Yeah.
You can catch the entire interview right here at Olé TV, somewhere on this page. Rich, the final single from her debut album, Hero, is up two positions to number eight this week.
Shit, I'd be rich.
Chris Young's Hangin' On is up one spot to number seven. FGL's Simple drops four spots to number six.
It's just that simple, S-I-M-P-L-E, simple as can be. It's just that simple, S-I-M-P-L-E, simple as can be.
Make 'em Like You from Dallas Smith moves up one position to number five.
Cause you one of a kind, make you stop on a dime. Yeah, you're sassy, you're classy, you're cool. No, they don't make 'em like that.
And Desperate Man from Eric Church is in at number four for a second week in a row. Eric Church, Desperate Man, number four for a second consecutive week. Kane Brown is off the market. Kane and his new bride, Caitlin J., tied the knot last Friday at Mint Springs Farm in Franklin, Tennessee. That's just outside of Nashville. Kane shared the news in a wedding photo posted on his Instagram account. They hosted 200 guests at the farm. After the wedding, the pair celebrated with a bouncy house. I guess it's like a bouncy castle, just bigger. Or maybe smaller. And Kane revealed a tattoo of Caitlin's name tattooed on his hand in an Instagram story. October has been a good month for Kane. In addition to getting hitched, he was country music's biggest winner at the American Music Awards, taking home three trophies, Best Country Album, Top Male Country Artist, and Best Country Song for his multi-platinum international number one smash hit, Heaven. While the good times keep on rolling, Kane's current hit, Lose It, moves up six positions to number three this week.
The way your dance is swinging to the music, girl, that body and high.
And Blue Tacoma from Russell Dickerson moves up one spot to number two.
Always having your hand to hold in a blue Tacoma, California. Ooh, if heaven is anywhere, it's right here.
Russell Dickerson, Blue Tacoma, up one spot to number two this week. Luke Combs has arrived. He was recently featured in a Mean Tweets segment on Jimmy Kimmel.
Keep the fact that Luke Combs looks like the guy who changes your oil at Jiffy Lube.
She got the message.
It's not that funny.
It's a little funny.
A little funny when I screw up like that? She Got the Best of Me is the number one song in the country. I guess it's not a tutorial. It's not a how to do one of these anymore, is it, when I screw it up? Luke Combs, She Got the Best of Me, is the number one song in the country for a third week in a row. Or you could watch it and say, look, he just moves on. Doesn't make a big deal out of it.
Every night, a different town, she follows me around. So you get what's left of me. Yeah, you get what's left of me. Cause she got the best of me.
Luke Combs, She Got the Best of Me, the number one song in the country for three straight weeks now. All right, that is a wrap. Subscribe to Olay TV and never miss a thing. Please check out my countdown on the radio. 2 hours, all the songs, all the interviews. It's on any real country, new country, CFCW, or Kix, Newfoundland station, 21 stations in all, carrying it across Canada. We've got your country covered. We're also on Facebook, and you can find me on Twitter and Instagram at the Paul McGuire. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Hey, I'm Paul McGuire. Thanks for tuning in. Click here. Here? I'm not a weatherman. Whatever. Click here to subscribe. Somewhere here to subscribe for more from Olay TV. And if you would be so kind, please like and share this video.